Your former colleague, Tom Libous, died from cancer 2 days ago, and in session yesterday, you celebrated his life. Let's take a look. He had some legal problems in the end, so it's unfortunate to see that being talked about on some sites because he was really known to so many as a charismatic and steadfast leader. Since you worked with him in the Senate for so many years, I'd like to ask you, what will you remember about Tom Libous?
Well, just what's going on right now, everybody's clapping for him on that shot. He made it clear, he knew he was sick, but he made it clear to a lot of people during the course of his carrying the duties that I have now, the floor leader, that he didn't like these morbid situations where people would remember him and make these comments and everybody's sad and there's a moment of silence. Actually, Rebecca Wood, who's one of the attorneys for the Senate, was very close to him. And she brought that to the attention to the majority leader, they came up with this idea. This is the way to recognize him, by clapping, not being morbid and a moment of silence. So he was upbeat to the last time I spoke to him. I mean, he went through literal hell for the last 7 years. And he was even coming back to preside over the Senate while charges were pending against him for these allegations and ultimately proven that he helped his son get a job and that sort of thing, which obviously ruined his reputation forever. But what we remember is a vigorous guy, a guy who was always humorous, always cordial to whether you're a Democrat or Republican, and made the lives of New Yorkers better by his presence.
Mm-hmm. One of his main things was the dedicated highway and bridge fund. He'd always talk about that on his program.
Well, I did too, but not as much as he did, because he was chair of transportation for a while. And when he was chair, whenever there was a bunch of money put in the budget for transportation, he ensured and made certain that it would be equitably divided between upstate and downstate. And when the Democrats took control, the New York City Democrats took control in 2009, 2010, that procedure was broken. And now we finally are catching up to where it should be, where it's equitable again, because there was something done in the budget this year. But that was one of his major issues that he kept working on.